Hi friends, welcome to our YouTube channel. Today we have to discuss about C program for performing arithmetic operations using functions. We already know that arithmetic functions are addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So these operations are called as arithmetic operations. In the previous programs, we are already solved the same program by using switch case, and without using also switch case, we are performing the arithmetic operations. But here in this program, we have to perform the arithmetic operations using functions. These five operations that can be performed by using functions. Okay, now we can go for the implementation of program. Hash include stdio.h standard input output header file. Second header file is hash include cbo.nivo.h. Next, we have to write function prototype int add int comma int semicolon int sub, that means subtraction, int comma int. Next, int mul, that means multiplication. It can take two parameters. Next, int division, div, int comma int. Next, int moddiv, modular division. It can take two parameters, int comma int. So these five are the function prototypes. These function prototypes tells to the compiler, these are the functions I am using in the program. Next one, void main. Every C program starts its execution with the main function. Main function does not return anything, so that we have to write void before the main function. Void is an empty data type. Now I am declaring int a comma b comma p comma q comma r comma s comma t. So these 7 variables can be declared as integer variables. Okay, next one, clrser, clear screen function. It clears the output screen. This function is available in the hash include cbo.nivo.h header file, so that we have to include this header file to our program. Next, printf, enter a and b values. A and b values, these values are read from the keyboard by using scanf function. So scanf, here we have to use %d because a and b variables can be declared as integer variables. So these two variables are read from the keyboard by using scanf function. Next one, here p is equal to add of a comma b. Here this is a calling function. Add function is a calling function. It can take two parameters. After that, so printf, we have to print the result. Addition of given two numbers, given two numbers equal to percentage d slash n double quotes n comma p, because the addition of these two numbers a and b is stored in the result p, then p value can be printed. Next, q is equal to sub of a comma b. We are calling the subtraction function. So after executing the subtraction function in the called function, so the result we are getting, that result can be assigned to the variable q. So then that value is printed. Subtraction of given two numbers is equal to percentage d slash n double quotes and comma q. Next one, r is equal to multiplication function we are calling mul of a comma b. So then we have to print the result. So print f multiplication of given two numbers is equal to percentage d slash n double quotes and comma r. Next one, s is equal to dib of a comma b. So we are calling the division function. Printf division of given two numbers is equal to percentage d slash n double quotes and comma s. Next, t is equal to mod dib, modular division function we are calling a comma b. After that we are printing the result. So printf modular division of given two numbers is equal to percentage d slash n double quotes and t. Next, after that get ch function, then main close. Now we are calling the calling function add function, then the control goes to the called function. So in the called function, int a comma b. So this is the called function of addition. So int c is equal to a plus b return c semicolon. Next one, now we are writing the called function for subtraction. Int sub of int a comma int b int c semicolon. C is equal to a minus b. Next, return c. Next, we are writing the called function for multiplication. Int mul of int a comma int b. Within the function we are declaring variable c. So c is equal to A into B, return C. Next, we have to write the called function for division int div of int A comma int B. Next, we are declaring a local variable int C. Next, C is equal to A divided by B, semicolon, return C, semicolon. Next, last function, modular division, we are calling modular division function. We have to write that called function for modular division int A comma int B. In that called function, we are writing a local variable, that is a C. C is the integer variable. C is equal to A modulus operator B. Next, return C. So here in the main program, we are calling five calling functions. So first, P is equal to add A comma B. Add is the calling function, that is function name. It can take two parameters, A and B. So whenever we are calling the add function in the main program, the control transferred from 14th line to 26th line. In the 26th line, we are writing the called function for add function. Int add int A comma int B. So whatever the parameters we are passing in the calling function of the main program, so here A and B are the actual parameters. That parameters are copied into formal parameters of the called function A and B. Once we are copying the values from calling function to called function, so then with that values, we are performing the addition operation. So C is equal to A plus B. After performing the addition operation, that result is stored in variable C. Then we have to return the addition result value. So it returns the integer type, so that we have to write int before the function name add. So now the program control can be transferred from 30th line to 14th line. That result can be assigned to the variable P on the left hand side. Then we have to print the resultant value. So addition of given two numbers is equal to %d slash and double quotes and P. So the addition result is stored in variable P and print that result. Now, next we are calling the subtraction function in the main program. So sub of A comma B. So A and B are the actual parameters. So whatever the values that are stored in the actual parameters, that are copied into the formal parameters, then the program control can be transferred from calling function to called function. So the program control can be transferred from 16th line to 32 line. Then actual parameter A value is copied into formal parameters A in 32 line. Actual parameter B value can be copied into formal parameter B. So once we are copying the actual parameter values into formal parameters, now we have to perform the subtraction operation. C is equal to A minus B, where C is the integer variable that is declared in the subtraction function. So once we are performing the subtraction operation, now we are return the resultant value. So the resultant value is stored in variable C. So C contains the integer result, so that we have to write int data type before the function name sub. So then the program control can be transferred from 36th line to 16th line, that result can be assigned to the variable Q. So now we have to print the subtraction result that is stored in variable Q. Next, after that we are calling the multiplication function MUL of A comma B, where A and B are the actual parameters. So A and B values are read from the keyboard. Whatever the values that are read from the keyboard, that values are stored in A and B. So the program control can be transferred from calling function 18th line to 38th line. So actual parameter A value is copied into formal parameter A. Actual parameter B value is copied into formal parameter B. So once we are copying that values into the formal parameters, now we are performing the multiplication operation by declaring the variable C in this multiplication function, because the multiplication result is stored in variable C. So after that, that result is returned. So returned the value stored in variable C is integer type, so that we have to write int before the function name multiplication. So now the program control can be transferred from 42 line to 18th line. So that result can be assigned to the variable R on the left hand side. Now that result is printed. Multiplication of given two numbers is equal to percentage D slash and double quotes and R. Okay. Next, we are calling the division function. S is equal to div of A comma B. So here function name is div and the actual parameters are A and B. So these parameter values are read from the keyboard by using scanf function. That values are stored in variable A and variable B. These are called as actual parameters. Whenever we are calling the calling function division, the program control can be transferred from 20th line to 44 line. So actual parameter A value is copied into formal parameter A in the called function. Actual parameter B value is copied into formal parameter B in the called function. Once we are getting the values of A and B in the formal parameters, we are perform the division operation and store the result in variable C. So variable C is integer type, so that we have to write int data type before the function name div. After that, return C. So then the program control can be transferred from 48th line to 20th line by using return statement. The result is stored in variable S. After that, we have to print the value that is stored in variable S. Next, we are calling the last function, modular division function. Okay, MOD div of A comma B. This is a calling function. Function name is MOD div. A and B are the actual parameters. These parameter values are read from the keyboard by using scanf function. Now A value is stored, B value is stored. Whenever we are calling the MOD div function, the program control can be transferred from 22 line to 50th line. So the actual parameter A value is copied into formal parameter A in 50th line. The actual parameter B value is copied into formal parameter B in 50th line. So once we are getting the A value and B value from the calling function, then we have to perform the modular division operation between A and B and returns the result in variable that is stored in variable C. So variable C contains the resultant value. Its data type is int, so that we have to write int before the function name MOD div. Okay. So after that, return C value. So by using the return statement, the program control can be transferred from 54th line to 22 line. That resultant value can be assigned to the variable t on the left hand side. Then we are printing the resultant value that is stored in variable c. Okay. So printf modular division of given two numbers is equal to percentage d slash n double quotes n t. So after that, so we are terminating the program. Okay. So this is the program. So first we have to save the program. Alt F, yes, arithmetic. Now we have to compile the program. So we are getting zero warnings and zero errors. Press enter. Next we have to run the program. For running the program we have to use the control F9, control plus F9. After that press enter. So the control goes to the output screen. Enter A and B values. Now I am giving A value is 5 and B value is 2. Okay. So then press enter. So addition of given two numbers is equal to 7. That is 5 plus 2, 7. Subtraction of given two numbers, that is 5 minus 2, is equal to 3. Multiplication of given two numbers is equal to 5 into 2, that is equal to 10. Division of given two numbers is equal to 5 by 2, so that is equal to 2. So we are taking two integer values so that we are getting the integer result. Actually it is 2.5, but it can take only up to integer value. So 5 by 2 is equal to 2.5. in that one integer value is 2, so that division of given two numbers is equal to 2 is printed. Next, modular division of given two numbers is equal to 5 can be divided with 2. Okay, then what is the remainder value we are getting? So 1. So modular division operator always returns the remainder value. 5 can be divided with 2, we can get the remainder value 1. So modular division of 5 and 2 is a 1. Okay, so this is the output of the given program. So once again we have to run the program. So I am entering 20 and 5. Okay. So addition result 25, subtraction result 15, multiplication result 100, division result 4, and modular division result 0. Remainder value 0. So thank you. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on the like button and share this video to your friends and classmates. If you have any doubts, please put your doubts in the comment box. I will clarify your doubts. So thank you. Thank you one and all for watching this video.